Billionaire Clive Palmer could play a crucial role in determining who wins next month's election. Preferences from his United Australia Party will prove crucial in a string of seats where the vote is too close to call.
It all started so well.
I'm Belinda Hassan, the Labor candidate for Dawson.
The local candidate front and centre for a feel-good announcement.
Yeah, that's good.
Before suddenly heading for the doors.
So you think they could be reviewed if Labor gets into government?
I don't know, sorry.
Unable to explain her comments that the Adani coal mine could be reviewed.
Why not? Why won't you explain that comment about Adani, a key issue in your electorate? Ms. Hassan.
Belinda Hassan making a speedy exit from the Harrop Park Country Club.
I have no plans to review the approvals. If I'm Prime Minister, I will adhere to the law of the land. I'm not going to be intimidated or bullied by environmental activists or big mining companies.
Scott Morrison claiming to deliver a kick to the economy. Promising a $100 million business growth fund to help a quarter of a million new small businesses juggle their equity over the next 5 years.
Small and family businesses have always been at the heart of our plans to grow our economy.
Dodging more than just questions about preference deals with Clive Palmer.
We'll have the discussions, as we do with many parties, we'll come to a view.
Sorry, there's only one person who's ever been resurrected, and I'm not going to compare Clive Palmer to him.
His relentless $30 million advertising blitz...
Reject Labor's lies.
...appears to have paid dividends. With the vote locked 50-50 in Herbert and the United Australia Party with a primary vote of 14%, preferences will be crucial. According to News Poll, it's a similar story in three other key electorates.
I'm a bit revolted, actually. They've got nothing to offer.
We need a fair go. And he didn't give his workers a fair go.
John Howard campaigning in the Sydney seat of Reed.
I think Bill Shorten as Prime Minister of Australia would be the most beholden Prime Minister since World War II to the union movement.
Admitting he'd only just met the candidate.
Yes, of course we met today. I arrived and had... I hadn't met her before, no. No, I literally hadn't, but so what?
And for all the talk of voter apathy, we now know Australians are lining up for this election in record numbers. 750,000 names have been added to the electoral roll, with more than 16 million Australians delivering a record-breaking enrolment rate of 96.8%. The youth vote is also breaking records, higher now than it was for the Marriage Equality Survey, with 88.8% of eligible 18 to 24-year-olds enrolled to vote on May 18. Brett Mason, SBS World News.